arts and education, was how we have these intelligences that are very different from each other. And unfortunately, in our culture in particular, we only really value words and numbers often. So if you're in school and you are a genius at moving, you might be lucky and be in a school and at least you get to play sports. If your inner genius is in music, these days you might have a hard time. So you've got to find it for yourself. So as we look at these things, Howard Gardner is a big inspiration for the way I think about intelligences and how we each have to look at and find our intelligence. It's a little hard to read, but for example, musical terms might be harmonize, infer, synthesize, interpret, pattern, compose, transpose. These are just sort of words that come into your bigger meaning of having a musical intelligence. Alrighty. And so what is rewarded, what is taught? We are not passive couch potatoes. Matthew Fox, who's one of my favorite theologians, says that we're supposed to be making. And from our human heritage, we were makers. But we now live in a world where usually you go out and buy everything you need. So you have to find what is your inner maker need to make. What satisfies that urge? We've got imagination. We're starting with imagination. All of us come into the world, if you've ever been around 5 years old, 4-year-olds or 5-year-olds when they start being able to talk, you know they are vibrantly alive with their imaginations. So what you can bring to yourself in imagination is letting it go and finding it and rediscovering it. I think I always ask people in my creativity workshops and things, think about what you really loved doing as a kid and how can you bring a little essence of that into what you're doing in your everyday lives now. You may not be able to, you know, pull out the Play-Doh, but maybe you can. I mean, it's cheap. Go buy it. Or you might want to do it with bread dough now. You feed your imagination with your observations. And that's what we're going to talk a little bit more about. So this sensory alphabet came from my early education in arts and education in theater program as a kid that I went into when I was 12. And this vocabulary was used by this theater company at Baylor University and then at Trinity University under kind of the direction of Paul Baker and Janine Wagner, is a list of 9 lenses or filters. That's good. And those 9 filters are things you can kind of put on and take off. So when you're looking at the world, you probably have some that are really strong. So everybody close your eyes right now. What do you remember about the person who's sitting next to you at this very moment? Is it their clothes? Is it their posture? Is it their hairstyle? Is it the way they're holding their body? You know, you don't have to answer this out loud, but just think, what did you really hold on to with that? Also, think about these objects up here. Which one of these might be the one you wanted to explore or investigate? All of these: space, texture, color, shape, sound, movement, line, rhythm, and light are that vocabulary of 9 sensory elements. And we each have strengths of those. They sound like art words, like, you know, a visual artist might use, or even theater words because they came from a theater perspective, but they're, you know, it's like what in your field of study or what you do in your vocation or avocation, which of these is really strong and important? Do you use color? Do you use line? And we're going to show some videos that give a little bit more explanation of that. Okay, Linda? And what do you want to do? Pay attention to what you attend to. Learn to honor the process. as well as the product. We're often so product-oriented that if we get frustrated if it's not how it came out because it doesn't match the picture we get. But if you keep working, you may find you have to build certain skills. And as Linda said, playing is really the heart of your creative work. That if you give yourself permission to play and not be completely purpose-oriented in what you're making and what you're doing, you're going to make discoveries along the way. Media is important for some of us. Trying out a lot of different media and figuring out what is it that your hands respond to, that your heart responds to, that your eyes respond to. And I will say again, you know, something like owning a business, being a business manager, that is just as creative, or maybe more so in our world, as being a painter or a poet or a musician. So, but what are the materials that you have to be able to work with as a business manager or as a chef? Then you have to know something about your own process. How do you start? This is how I think of the big process of creativity and creative work. Collecting, playing, inventing, where you bring something to a form, where you get it to that point where at least it's something that you can share and that you want to talk to about other people. And then you refine and edit, and it's a big circle. And you reflect on it, and then you go back and you start at the beginning again with maybe collecting and adding. And, yeah, just speak through that. What inspires you? Again, this may give you a clue to your unique voice in whatever media or material you're working with. Is it folk music? Is it folk art? Is it symphonic music? Is it pop? You know, each of us has this kind of leaning towards something, and that leaning is going to be something that informs what you need to create to make your best life. And these are all stepping stones to finding your own creative path. That as you work, and it can happen at any age, it may be that you felt like, well, I spent, 40 years at a boring job, but you must have been getting something out of it besides a paycheck. So what is it that you need to remember about that, as well as what did you do when you were 7 years old and love? And it's never too late to find your own creative path. A lot of people think, well, I'm never going to be a concert pianist because I've started too late. Well, it's too bad. Maybe you won't be a concert pianist, but you might find the enjoyment of music that a concert pianist has in learning to play the piano at an older age, or learning to oil paint, or starting to write and journal and see if a poem pops up. So it's not too late. And now we're going to show you some of these little, and we know that the sound is a little iffy, but these are three little of the videos that we collaborated on that give you a little bit more depth about those elements, because as I said, they're not just art things. Human vision is distinguished by the color detecting ability of our eyes. And so for us, color is often the element of discernment and the visual language of emotion. Green with envy, seeing red, walking around under a black cloud, emotion transforms itself into colorful characters, colorful language, poetic passion. Paint on canvas creates sunny weather or an emotional storm, and music paints a picture, solemn or sprightly.
Where is your color sense alive? In cooking or chemistry, stargazing or paint mixing, finding rainbows, delighting in a feather's iridescence, or in an outlandishly fashionable fashion sense. Look around you right now. Pay attention to color through all your senses, feelings, and actions, subtle or obvious, brash or timid, loud or soft. Look for color in your world.
Okay, that was color. Who has an affinity for color in this room? Okay. This one is lime. Oops.
Line, the elemental foundation for print and number, has determined much about 20th century life and success in our culture. Isobars, arteries, fault lines, line drives, battle lines, lines of credit, timelines, lines of type, notes, numbers, and people. Stretchy, slinky, fixed or floating, dotted or dashed, lines connect two or more points. And the points are, as mathematicians remind us, infinite. Writers pen storylines. Programmers, lines of code. Biologists decipher lines of DNA. Entrepreneurs develop product lines. Singers follow melodic lines. Jazz musicians improvise upon them. Where do you enter the element of line? As storyteller or scribbler? With a delight for a maze? Or an appreciation for ballet? With stitches, big or small? What lines show up in your life and in your art? Movement is about change and getting from here to there, from up to down, from then to now. We talk about how ideas move us, how ambition gets us there, that responsibility keeps us tied down, how our imaginations run away and our philosophies collide. A storyline must move right along or it loses our attention. Cycles of days and years and viewpoints become the stuff of history. Cycles in our bodies, in weather, in nature, present whole worlds of study. Kinesthetic learners must move into knowledge, finding meaning of a concept by physically moving into it, doing to learn. Movers include, but are not limited to, explorers, botanists, meteorologists, dancers, acrobats and athletes, construction workers, race car drivers, and all of us who move through days and nights, games and rituals, making and building with our hands and whole selves with movements, big and small. Can you depict movement in a still image? How do you capture it on a piece of paper or with a brush full of paint? What ways can you see and track movement over time and through space? How does movement help you tell your story in your artwork?
related rhythm and movement.
Rhythm is the heartbeat element, holding things together in big and little patterns. We each have a personal rhythm that is distinct as our fingerprints, recognizable beneath the changing tides of emotional rhythms that rock and roll us through the day. Rhythm, at first thought, is audible and invisible. Drum beats, finger taps, cadences, and cacophony. But imagine the world without stripes, dots, and dashes, without repeats in a quilt or in a yard of calico. Do you notice visual patterns of steps and windows, lines of shoes, veins in a leaf, or trees in a landscape? Think about seasons and waves and the circadian rhythms of sleep and wake. Without rhythm, who could be a pianist, a mathematician, a poet, an actor or director, a basketball player, a waiter, a politician, or a juggler? How does rhythm show up in your work? By setting a mood, quiet or angry, orderly or exploding? Take a look at the way shapes march across the surface. Lines lead to a vanishing point. What ways do quilt blocks connect you to the past? What beats, pings, and patterns are carrying your art into the future?
Let's take a few moments to take that information inside, into the realm beyond time and space and movement and rhythm, into a place where all melts into the singular, precious, present moment now. With eyes open or eyes closed, with a path to the sacred which is well worn through a particular mantra, religious belief, or through the breath which binds you to all that is and all that is becoming now. Feel that just for this moment, there is nothing you need to do but be creative. For all of life is expressing through you, always has been, always will be. That is the nature of the creative one, the source that has brought all into manifestation, is expressing through you now, through this breath, this precious present breath now, inhale, leading to exhale. Leading to inhale, leading to exhale. There is nothing you need to do to make this happen. You are simply aligned with that which is. Resting in this precious moment. Bring into conscious awareness all that has brought you here, all the teachers and parents, friends, challengers and challenges. All are the gift of life. I having drawn in all that is past, grounded in the present, open to the exquisiteness of the future, an infinite field of possibilities waiting to express in you at work, at home, in your art, in your garden, in your silence. In your own way, in your own heart, lift up a prayer of possibility for what is yet to come in your life. Open to the moreness, more life, light, color, line, rhythm, space, texture, expressing through you. And finally, open to all of creation, all beings, all nations. Being touched by your willingness to express peace and love and creative energy. Now. And now. Feel that you are blessed and are a blessing. All of creation be blessed by your willingness to remember and express this as personally and collectively we open. So it is. Amen.